This is the fourth lecture on waves. In the earlier three lectures, we have discussed longitudinal waves, transverse waves, formation of standing waves, and the phenomenon of beats. Today, we intend to discuss velocity of sound and Doppler effect. Remember, first of all, that sound waves are longitudinal waves, and the velocity of such waves in a medium is given by v equal to square root of b by rho, where b is the bulk modulus of the medium and rho is the density of the medium. Remember that sound waves can propagate only in a medium, they cannot propagate in vacuum. In a solid bar or rod, b is replaced by the Young's modulus, and we get the velocity equal to the square root of Young's modulus by the density of the medium. For a gas, we have already done that the bulk modulus is equal to gamma times p, where gamma is the ratio of Cp to Cv, and therefore, the velocity of sound is given by gamma p by rho, square root of that. The following points may be noted in connection with the speed of sound. The speed of sound depends on the nature of the medium and its density. We have seen in the formula that we have b and rho, so the nature of the medium and its density. In solids, it depends upon the bulk modulus and on Young's modulus in rods or pipes. In fluids, the speed of sound depends on the compressibility and density. In an ideal gas, it does not vary with pressure or density because both change in the same proportion because of Boyle's law. Recall that Boyle's law is PV equal to constant at a given temperature. So, P and V, they change accordingly, and therefore, P by rho remains constant. In an ideal gas, the speed of sound varies with temperature because the ratio P by rho depends on the temperature through the equation of state. We shall see that in a moment. The rate of change of sound speed is 0.6 meters per second for every degree Celsius of temperature. In an ideal gas, the speed of sound also varies with gamma, as we have seen in the formula earlier. In air, the speed of sound is determined by the atmospheric conditions, mainly by temperature and to a small extent by humidity. At a given pressure, the speed increases slightly with humidity, as mixture of water vapor in air reduces slightly its density, and we have seen that the velocity of sound is inversely proportional to the square root of density. Let us take an example to fix these ideas. If c denotes the velocity of sound and nu the root mean square velocity of the molecules of a gas, show that ratio v by c does not depend on temperature. We know that p is equal to 1 by 3 nm v squared. We have done that in kinetic theory. And if we multiply it by v, then we get p v equal to 1 by 3 nm v squared into v, and this nm becomes density. Using the equation of state, p v equal to r t and nm equal to density rho, we get this v equal to square root of 3 mu r t by p v. Mu is the number of moles. In a similar way, we can write C. C is gamma p by rho. Now, you use the equation of state. So, you can write p v is equal to r t. So, gamma mu r t by rho v. And now, you can see pick the ratio v by C. And you see that this ratio is independent of temperature. Let us take another example. A transverse wave propagates along x axis and is represented by y of x and t equal to 6.5 sine 2 pi into x by 4 minus 2 t minus 1 by 8, where x is in meters and t is in seconds. What is the instantaneous phase difference between the oscillatory motion of points separated by 3 meters? Let me remind you that in a wave, as the wave moves, the particle, they keep on moving along their mean position. They do not move at all except along their mean position. So, we are asked to find out the phase difference between particles which are separated by 3 meters. Now, remember that this quantity in brackets into 2 pi is the phase of the wave, and all that we have to do is to put the value x equal to 1 meter and x equal to, let us say, 4 meter, and then or x equal to 0 meters and x equal to 3 meters, and find the difference in this function 2 pi x by 4 minus 2 t minus 1 by 8. And if you do that, you can find that the difference in two values in the phase difference in radians, and in this case it is 3 pi by 2. Another example, sound waves travel at 350 meters per second through warm air and at 3500 meters per second through brass. Find the wavelength of a 700 hertz acoustic waves as it enters brass from warm air. Acoustic waves are again sound waves, longitudinal waves. And if you remember, then you must be sure that the frequency of a wave is its intrinsic property, it does not change. So, when the wave enters from one medium to the other, the frequency remains constant. What changes is the wavelength and the velocity. So, let us write the velocity. Velocity is, you know, lambda times nu. So, in medium 1, lambda 1 nu is equal to 350 meters per second. In the other mediums, lambda 2 times nu is 3500 meters per second. So, if you divide one by the other, you will get lambda 2 by lambda 1, which is 10. So, the wavelength increases 10 times when it enters from the warm air to brass. Another example, a change in the temperature of a medium changes. Frequency of sound waves? No, because frequency, as I have said many times, is a property of the wave, intrinsic property of the wave, it does not change. Amplitude of the sound waves? No, the temperature does not change the amplitude. Wavelength of the sound waves? It can change wavelength because it changes velocity. Since the frequency does not change, the wavelength will change with the change of temperature. Loudness depends on the amplitude, and amplitude is constant, does not depend upon the temperature. And therefore, the option 3, wavelength of the sound waves changes with the change of temperature of the medium. What is the nature of the transverse displacement of a string clamped at both ends if the equation is given by y of x t equal to 0.06 sine 2 pi x by 3 cosine 120 pi into t. Now, you see the x part has been separated from the t part, and therefore, this equation signifies stationary waves. So, these waves are stationary waves, and in a stationary wave, you remember that you have on a string, you have loops of string going up and down, going up and down. And the particle in each loop also goes up and down in phase, but the amplitude is different. They are in phase, all three particles are in phase, going up like this, coming down like this, they are in phase, but there is amplitude difference between this, this and this. By this time, your concepts of wave motion must have been fixed. So, let us take another topic, again in the wave motion, but now a different topic, Doppler effect. Doppler effect is more popularly known as red shift. You know, in popular literature, the red shift is more popular because the light from the stars are moving away from us, the light from the stars gets shifted to red. That is why it is known as red shift. And so, when a source of sound is moving, or when an observer is moving relative to a source of sound, the frequency of sound heard by the observer is not the same as that emitted by the source when at rest. So, let us see what happens. We have a source which is emitting sound waves, and we have an observer at a distance, let us say. This observer, if this observer moves towards the source, or if this source moves towards the observer, whatever frequency the observer hears is different from the frequency emitted by the source when at rest. That is Doppler effect. Let us see more graphically. the observer is at rest. So, I have taken two observers, one on this side and one on this side, and car horn is the source of sound. And since both the observers are at rest, since the source of sound is at rest, there is no change in the frequency emitted by the source and heard by the observers. Now, the source now is moving towards the right. And what happens? The wave fronts get compressed. And this fellow towards whom the source is moving hears a frequency which is increasing. And this fellow who is in a direction from whom the source is moving away, he hears a frequency which is decreasing. So, if the source is moving towards the observer, the frequency increases. If the source moves away from the observer, then as for this observer, the frequency decreases. So, when an observer approaches a source or a source approaches the observer, the frequency heard is higher than when the source is at rest. When the observer is moving away from the source or the source is moving away from the observer, the frequency heard is lower than the frequency when the source is at rest. We shall denote by V the velocity of sound, by V O the velocity of the observer, and by V S the velocity of the source. And when both source and observer are moving, then the frequency heard by the observer is nu, which is equal to nu 0, nu 0 is the frequency emitted by the source when at rest, into V plus V O by V plus V S. Now, we remember that as the source approaches the observer, then the observer hears a higher frequency. So, as the source approaches the observer, V S must be negative, so that the denominator is smaller and the frequency heard is higher. When the observer moves towards the source, again, we expect the frequency to rise. And therefore, when the observer moves towards the source, V 0 must be positive, so that V plus V 0, the numerator is higher. Similarly, you can talk about V S and V O increasing or decreasing depending upon the motion of the source and the observer. Use your common sense. As the observer or the source approach each other, the frequency must increase. As they move away from each other, frequency must decrease. And in accordance with that notion, V S and V O can be positive or negative. In the following examples, we take the velocity of sound equal to 340 meters per second, but not specified. In several problems, the velocity is generally not specified, and therefore, we shall take it to be 340 meters per second. And V O is the velocity of the observer, and V S is the velocity of the source, and small v is the velocity of the sound. With this information, let us take a few examples on the Doppler shift. You blow a whistle at a frequency of 340 hertz. Your friend runs towards you with a speed of 10 meters per second. What is the frequency your friend would hear? Suppose the friend is at rest and you run towards the friend with the same speed blowing the whistle. What frequency would your friend hear? Speed of sound, as I have said already, we take as 340 meters per second. Now, in the first case, when your friend runs towards you, the frequency must increase, and therefore, V O must be taken as positive, so that the frequency increases. So, just calculate 340 into 1 plus 10 by 340, which is 350 hertz. When you run, that is the source runs towards the observer, again the frequency must increase, and therefore, V S must be taken as negative, so that the denominator decreases and the frequency increases. So, if we put the numbers, we get 350.3 hertz. There is not much difference, but the two things are still different. One, the observer is running towards the source, another, source is running towards the observer. The driver of a car traveling with a speed of 20 meters per second towards a hill sounds a horn of frequency 620 hertz. If the velocity of sound in air is 330 meters per second, what is the frequency of the reflected sound heard by the driver. So, what we do in this case is, there is a hill and we imagine an observer, imaginary observer stationed there. So, as the car moves, that observer hears the frequency of the sound given out by the car. And since the car is moving towards the observer, the frequency must increase. So, imagine a stationary observer on the hill, the source is moving towards the observer. So, Vs is negative because the frequency must increase, and V0 is 0 because the observer is at rest. The frequency heard by the imaginary observer is F1 equal to F0 into V by V minus Vs. So, if you calculate, it is 660 hertz. You see, sometimes the symbol F is used for frequency instead of nu. Now, in the second part, it is this frequency which is reflected by the hill, which is heard by the driver. This observer now becomes the source and approaches the heard by the driver, now observer approaching the hill. Now, the driver is the observer and the source is the observer on the hill. So, again Vs is 0 because the source now is at rest. The observer, the driver is moving with 20 meters per second. So, F2 is F1. Since the frequency must increase, Vo is positive. So, V plus Vo by V, and if you put the numbers, it becomes 700 hertz. In fact, you could have used only one formula, F equal to F0 into V plus V0 by V minus Vs. So, substitute the values and you will get the same number. This problem explains the principle of measurement of speed of your car by the traffic police. You must have seen the traffic police occasionally halting you or whoever is the driver with you, so that you are over speeding, when you are over speeding. How do they do that? They have a radar gun with them and they send a signal to the car. This signal is reflected by the moving car and the frequency changes, and the change in frequency is very small. So, you hear the beats between the frequency which is issued and the frequency which is heard. So, if you calculate the beats, you can calculate the frequency of the signal reflected from the car, and therefore, you can get the speed of the car. That is how the policeman calculates your speed and challenges you for over speeding. Radar device has now been replaced by a more accurate laser gun. See, laser gun is sends bunch of signals, and these signals are reflected by the car, and from the time of travel to the car and back by one signal, the next, and so on. By this, you can get the velocity of the car. In fact, this is a more accurate device, and now this is a modern device, and police uses these devices, the laser device. Example 13, you are standing on a pavement. You hear a siren of frequency 612 hertz as an ambulance approaches you. Ambulance approaches you, and therefore, its frequency must increase. When the same ambulance is receding away, is going away, you hear the siren at frequency 544 hertz. That is, the frequency now must decrease. What is the speed of the ambulance? So, we use that formula. In the first case, the frequency is heard is 612, the actual frequency is F0, and this must be given by F0 into 340 by 340 minus V. V is the speed of source, the ambulance coming towards you. So, V is negative. In the second case, V is positive. So, 544 is F0 into 340 by 340 plus V, and from these two equations, you can get both V and F0 if you like. So, F0 is 576 hertz. Let us take another example. A source of sound and an observer are approaching each other with a velocity of 20 meters per second. If the original frequency of the source is 640 hertz, what is the frequency heard by the observer? Now, both are approaching each other. So, we can take one by one. We can see the source approaching and then the observer approaching. In both cases, the frequency must increase. Therefore, when the source is approaching, F1 is 640 into 340 by 340 minus 20, because the frequency must increase. So, 680. And then the second case, 680 into 340 plus 20 by 340, which gives 720. It does not matter the order, whether you calculate first the observer approaching and then the source approaching, it doesn't matter. You can calculate as I have done here and you can show that you get the same result. Two friends are going away in opposite directions from a source of frequency 680 hertz with the same speed of 10 meters per second. See, here is a source, one friend is going this way, the other friend is going that way. What is the difference in the frequency observed? You see, in the formula you have seen that it doesn't matter which direction the observer moves, it is only the magnitude of the observer's velocity that matters. In this case, the velocity is the same. Therefore, this friend as well as this friend will hear the same frequency, and that frequency is 680 into 340 minus 10 by 340. So, it is 660 hertz, because the frequency is lower than this because the friends are going away from the source. You are cruising away at a speed of 20 meters per second on your motorbike. A policeman notices that you are over speeding. He follows you with a speed of 10 meters per second, sounding a siren at a frequency of 660 hertz. What is the frequency of the siren that you hear? You see, it's a common scene that you are moving away and the police is following you. So, you can use the procedure of earlier examples, or we can use both now, the frequency of the observer as well as the frequency of the source. Remember in this case that the observer is moving away, therefore, V0 will be negative, VO will be negative, and the source is approaching the observer because the police is following, and therefore, VS is also negative, and if you put these values, you get F equal to 640 hertz. So, as you move away and the police follows you, you hear a frequency of 640 hertz. You see, I have chosen typical examples to explain all aspects of the Doppler effect. You are sitting in an express train moving at 108 kilometers per hour. When it approaches a station and sounds a siren, you hear at a frequency of 620 hertz. At what frequency does a person standing on the platform of the station hear the siren? Now, you are at rest with the train, therefore, you would hear the same frequency as that of the train, right. So, the frequency of the train therefore is 620 hertz, and the observer at rest on the platform, the train is approaching the observer, and therefore, the frequency would increase. And since the source is moving, we have the Vs minus 30 in this case meters per second, and therefore, the frequency heard by the observer on the platform is 620 into 340 by 340 minus 30, which is 680 hertz. From the following data, calculate the rate of change of speed of sound per degree. You see, I have told you earlier that the speed of sound depends upon temperature. So, we are given this data. All that we have to do is to calculate the speed of sound at temperature T. We know the speed of sound at temperature 0 degrees Celsius, and therefore, we can find out the rate at which the speed of sound increases with the increase in temperature. So, get the speed of sound using 702. You see, let me state the problem again. Frequency of the siren of the police car is 732 hertz. Speed of the police car moving away from you is 15 meters per second. Frequency heard by you is 702 hertz. So, the current temperature is 35 degrees Celsius, and the speed of sound at 0 degrees Celsius is given as 330 meters per second. So, as I said, you find the speed at 35 degrees Celsius. You see, you hear a frequency 702, therefore, it must be equal to the frequency original 732 into V by V plus 15. And from this equation, you can get V. You see, in this case, 15 is positive because the frequency of the siren of police car is moving away from you, and therefore, 15 is positive, and you get from this equation V equal to 351 meters per second. So, this is the velocity at temperature 35 degrees C. This is the velocity given at 0 degrees C, and therefore, you can use this formula to calculate how much does it increase per degree increase in temperature. So, this is 351 minus 330, 351 minus 330 divided by 35 minus 0. We are of course assuming that the increase is uniform, and you get the result 0.6 meters per degree Celsius. You remember that this is the result I told you earlier on when we discussed the increase in the speed of sound with temperature. With this, we come to the end of the chapter on waves. In fact, we come to the end of syllabus of class 11. In the next lecture, we go to class 12 and we start with electrostatics.